More than 800,000 Cubans live in South Florida. You'll find them sipping small cups of strong coffee throughout the day and helping drive the local economy in upscale shopping and business districts. And in what's known as Little Havana, the older crowd flocks to Domino Park, rain or shine. For years, the GOP has depended on Cubans in Miami as a reliable vote. But now, the younger generation doesn't appear to share the same party loyalty or political concerns.
The older, the exile community that came in 59 and in the 60s was more focused on a real single mission, which was getting back to Cuba.
Jose Fuentes' dad emigrated from Cuba, so he speaks personally about younger Cubans. As a government lobbyist, Fuentes also speaks professionally and says young Cubans born here bring a different set of values to the table.
We want to hear that you've got a good tax code that helps working families. We want to know that you're doing better things for education.
New polling shows a political divide among Cuban Americans, with the younger generation less concerned about Cuban policy and more motivated by domestic issues. It makes sense to Al Cardenas, chair of the American Conservative Union.
Cuban Americans, when we first came to America, said, look, Republicans are against communism, they're for liberty, they're for freedom, we're with them. Now, they like what Republicans stand for, but they're also looking closely at the individuals and what they stand for.
That may explain why in 2012, Joe Garcia became Florida's first Cuban-American Democrat elected to Congress, why a record number of Cuban voters turned out for President Obama, and why those like J.C. Dare feel more liberal than their Cuban-born parents.
I consider myself in the modern world, not, you know, most Cuban-Americans are a bit conservative, so on. I consider myself in the moderate.
Political watchers call it a subtle shift that is worth watching. Latin American expert and Regent Provost Paul Bonicelli believes that Republicans should be concerned.
The first shock for the GOP is they never had to worry about that, and now you have to. And it's not just worry like keep me up at night, it's now I got to spend more money in an area that was a lock.
Here's the political equation. Cubans are key to Florida's Hispanic vote. Florida's Hispanic vote is critical to winning the state, and the state leads to the White House. Florida's 29 electoral votes are the fourth most in the country and make it a major battleground state. In addition to their impact on voting, younger Cubans could ultimately affect U.S. policy towards Cuba.
I think the younger generation looks at the embargo as something that maybe hasn't functioned, maybe we should change it, maybe we should negotiate.
And they're like a lot of younger Americans. They don't really listen so much to their parents and grandparents and what they're talking about. They want to strike out on their own. They want to have a different point of view. And that explains a lot of the apathy toward the anti-Castro movement.
Part of that turnaround can be seen in this recent poll showing 64% in Miami want normal relations between the U.S. and Cuba. Maybe that's why this handshake with Raul Castro at Nelson Mandela's memorial didn't make more waves than it would have in the past. For now, the Cuban vote remains one in transition, representing a newfound opportunity for Democrats and a new concern for the GOP. Reporting in Miami, Heather Sells, CBN News.